all chordates share four features that make all of us who we are. And the least developed among them are the notochordates or the cephalochordates, which look like this. And they have four distinct features that you will find in every single chordate, named after the spinal cord. So I'm sure you're guessing what is the first feature. Yep, they have a spinal cord, or at least something that looks like a spinal cord. That is called a notochord, which is kind of, you can say, a primitive form of a spinal cord. And yes, we have a notochord too, but it's reduced to these cartilaginous discs that are there just above the vertebra. And then you have the nerve cord called the dorsal hallow nerve cord, filled with nerve fibers that develops into the nervous system. The next thing that you need to look out for are the pharyngeal slits. In notochords, they just filter food. In fish, they develop like gills. And in us, well, surprise, surprise, we have them too. But they disappear before we are born. And finally, the tail, which helps aquatic animals swish through water. Peacocks show them off, make them so attractive. And our pet dogs let us know when they are super happy. And in us, well, it shrinks and becomes insignificantly small because we actually don't need them at all. So if you ask me, this phylum, the Notochordata, is giving us a little peek into the next phylum that's coming up, the Vertebrata, the most advanced and complicated phylum that there is. And so let's talk about us. We humans, being the self-obsessed set of people that we are, love talking about ourselves, and finally, it's time to do that. But you know what? We are right at the top of the ladder in the phylum Vertebrata, and we have our buddies like this fish and this birdie who are vertebrates too. So something must really get evolved up that ladder to go from this to this. All vertebrates are bilaterally symmetrical. They have the dorsal hallow nerve cord that introduced in notochords. They are triploblastic, have gill pouches or pharyngeal slits like their notochord buddies. They also have a fully developed coelom. And most importantly, the thing that makes us put them in a separate phylum, they have a vertebral column, which is basically a hard backbone that allows so many type of species to come along. It's too big to just have vertebrata, and so we divide them up and put them into several classes.
To keep learning with such engaging videos, download BYJU'S, the learning app, today.